Hello everyone. Thank you for joining the webinar on Migrate e-commerce solution to Red Hat OpenShift. I'll be your host for this webinar. My name is Faraz Saleem. I work as a business development manager at Royal Cyber. Let me introduce you to our presenters, our experts for the day. We have Shivam Mishra, represents Red Hat, also a solution architect and partner. We have got Dheeraj Purohit, practice lead IT managed services at Royal Cyber. Kamran Kanwar Siraj, technical lead at Royal Cyber. Finally, we have Dia Ahmed, OpenShift admin at Royal Cybers. These would be our experts for the day. Let me just give you a quick walkthrough on the agenda for this webinar. We will be talking about what is OpenShift and its architecture overview, difference between OpenShift, Kubernetes, and other Docker orchestration, what e-commerce solution OpenShift support. We'll be discussing on a case study on benefits of migrating HCL Commerce environment to OpenShift, how Royal Cyber can help businesses to develop a migration approach. Then we'll be showcasing a demo on the same, a quick walkthrough on Red Hat OpenShift IT managed services. Finally, we'll be having a live section where you can shoot your questions and queries on the above mentioned topics. If you need more clarity or if you need to know more information about the above mentioned topics, we would be happy to assist you with your questions and queries. I'll give you a brief overview about Royal Cyber so that you will have an understanding about who we are and what we do. Royal Cyber is a 20 plus year old company incorporated on 2002 with 1500 plus employees, in which 250 plus certified consultant, having 10 plus offices operating globally in 5 continents in 10 plus countries, serving more than 600 plus happy customers. The services we can offer: we are an IT consulting and digital transformation company, specializes in services, solution and software. When it comes to services, we can help you with digital commerce, robotic process automation, artificial intelligence, machine learning, blockchain, big data, mobility, DevOps, integration, business intelligence, etc. This is just a representation of few of our customers among the 600 plus happy customers we are serving. As you can see here, we have worked with Omega, Fletcher Building, L'Oreal, Agusta Sportswear, Brambleberry, Coppel, etc. We provide a high reliable and high performance solution using an association with SAP, HCL, Oracle, Microsoft, UiPath, Dell, Insight, and etc. Let me hand it over to Shivam. He'll take it from here. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Faraz, for the introduction. Now, we will quickly discuss about what is OpenShift. So now, before going further, it is very important to understand the product as what OpenShift is. So OpenShift is a platform that allows you to run containerized applications and workloads and is also powered by Kubernetes under the cover. Okay. So before going further, let's discuss the top two key technologies. A container is a ready to run software package containing everything needed to run an application. The code and any runtime it requires, the application, system libraries, the default values for any essential setting, and all bound together in a box. That is a container. Now, what is Kubernetes? Kubernetes is the container orchestrator, which governs how and where those containers will run, right? Now, what is OpenShift? OpenShift, you can say, is containers plus its orchestration, which is Kubernetes, plus the Red Hat additional tools, which is single sign-on technology, log management, monitoring stack based on Prometheus and Grafana, plus many tools which are critical for production development of containers. Okay. So OpenShift is an enterprise platform for container orchestration, While Docker is a container engine, in fact, it is also true that you can run Docker containers within OpenShift deployment, right? The open source project that actually powers OpenShift is called OKD. Now, when we talk about Kubernetes, so Kubernetes, everybody thinks that, you know, it is open source, anybody can deploy. It is true. But when we talk about mission critical workloads, when we talk about production workloads, you know, it becomes very complicated. You have to install, deploy, harden and operate, right? It is not only limited to installation. It is not hard to download and install Kubernetes. Getting it ready for production to run business critical applications for an enterprise takes a lot of time. You know, there are a number of things that needs to be pieced together and tested and hardened for operations. And that is why, you know, in the next slide, we are going to discuss about how OpenShift is built. You know, let's explain how we build OpenShift. You know, at Red Hat, we use 100% open source deployment model to deliver enterprise products, right? So we don't, you know, use any proprietary extensions also. So our source, our secret source is our ability to run dozens and hundreds of open source projects into production ready, stable, secure enterprise products that we support over many years, right? When the community declares a release ready, we typically find hundreds of defects that actually we fix in the corresponding downstream releases. We can do that because we have been contributing to Kubernetes and many other open source projects like OpenShift since day one. Red Hat is the largest enterprise developer of Kubernetes besides the owner of the Kubernetes project, which is Google. Now we will quickly discuss about the high level architecture of, you know, OpenShift. So this is the foundation of trusted enterprise Kubernetes platform. We add productive enhancements to deliver an application platform with all the components you need that are fully integrated to build, deploy and manage containerized application. So we have three major flavors in OpenShift. So first, obviously, we have the hardware wherever it is running, physical, virtual, private cloud, public cloud. Then obviously we have the RHEL lower layer, which is RHEL core OS. Above that, we have Kubernetes. Above that, we have cluster services, right? So till cluster services, we call it OpenShift Kubernetes engine. Then when we enhance it more into platform services, application services, and developer services, we add additional capabilities as given in the slides, right? Then we call it OpenShift Container Platform, which we are talking about. And above that, when we give it multi-cluster management so that you can manage all the OpenShift environments from a single pane of glass, then we call it Advanced Cluster Manager, which is also known as OpenShift Plus. Now, OpenShift is there are various versions. So this slide will help you understand that OpenShift is available as self-managed platform, right? And it is also available as a fully managed cloud service. I will discuss about the differences in the upcoming slides. The OpenShift Platform Plus is a self-managed software solution that you can deploy in your data center, public cloud, or edge location, right? The last one in the base, OpenShift with the Red Hat logo, right? And OpenShift managed services include OpenShift Dedicated, which includes ARO, you know, hosted off Azure, AWS, and Google, right? Especially IBM, right? Where you are fully managed, you know, jointly by Red Hat and the service provider partners. You can choose the model that, you know, best suits for your needs and the combination of both. Now we will discuss what is the difference, major difference between OpenShift and Kubernetes. To help, we have this wonderful slide, which will give you, I'll help you understand the differences with the help of car. So when we talk about the engine, right, the base of every car, so we will compare it with Kubernetes. So the base, which includes Kubernetes cluster services, Kubernetes, and custom OS running anywhere. So that is the engine. So that is what we call Kubernetes. Then when we, you know, build more parts on top of it, like monitoring, service mesh, tools, metrics, logging, CI/CD, when we add all that, then it becomes plus native services on Kubernetes. Now what Red Hat is giving, when it is managed, you know, and compiled all together as an assembled car, right, which has the signature of Red Hat, and it is tested and hardened by Red Hat community, then it becomes an assembled car. And when we are talking about running all this in which is fully managed, then actually you have the driver of the car as well, which acts like a chauffeur driven vehicle, like the Olas and Ubers of the world. That is called Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS, which is fully managed. Okay, I hope this will help you understand the difference as I explained, right? But you know, Red Hat, talking about the, you know, as a tech tick mark, what all is there in OpenShift Kubernetes engine or normal Kubernetes, and in OpenShift container platform. See, there are things which are common, but I will discuss about things which are not common, which are additional in OpenShift, which is user workload monitoring, which is metering and cost management SaaS service, which is web developer console, which is OpenShift serverless also, right? So the entire topic can take a lot of discussion, but these are the high level differences, right? OpenShift service mesh provides a platform for behavioral insight and operational control over your networked microservices, which is called, you know, this service is called service mesh. This is also additional in OpenShift container platform, right? So this was the overview. Now I will quickly, you know, hand it over and invite to Kamran to proceed with the e-commerce solution which they have, you know, done where with the help of OpenShift. Okay, thank you everybody.
Thanks, Shivam. So what e-commerce solution OpenShift supports? OpenShift, the container application platform by Red Hat, supports a wide range of e-commerce solution, including Magento, WooCommerce, Drupal Commerce, SAP Commerce, Atop, HCL Commerce, and Shopify. These are just some of the e-commerce solution that can be deployed over OpenShift. OpenShift provides a secure, scalable, and flexible platform for running e-commerce applications, making it an ideal choice for business looking to take their online sales to the next level. In today's presentation, we will see about the benefits of migrating HCL Commerce environment to OpenShift, and also we'll discuss about case study. So what is HCL Commerce? HCL Commerce is an e-commerce platform that enables business to build and manage online stores. It provides a comprehensive set of features and tools for creating personalized shopping experience, managing product catalogs, and processing payments. HCL Commerce is designed to meet the needs of business of all sizes, from small and medium-sized enterprise to large enterprises with complex e-commerce requirements. Some of the key features of HCL Commerce include multi-channel commerce, personalized shopping experience, integrated content management, product catalog management, payment processing. Overall, HCL Commerce is a robust and flexible platform for building and managing online stores, and can help business improve their e-commerce operation and drive growth. So what is the benefits of migrating HCL Commerce to OpenShift? Migrating to OpenShift can provide a range of benefits for business using HCL Commerce, allowing them to improve the performance, security, and scalability of their e-commerce environment while reducing cost and making management easier. There are several benefits of migrating HCL Commerce to OpenShift, including developer benefits, operator benefits, infrastructure benefits, and security benefits. So when we talk about the developer benefits, when using OpenShift as a platform for developing and deploying e-commerce application, we have first automatic provisioning, means OpenShift automates the provisioning of infrastructure, allowing developers to focus on writing code and building applications rather than managing servers and infrastructures. Simplified deployment, OpenShift provides a platform for continuous integration and delivery, allowing developers to easily deploy new updates and features to e-commerce applications. Then we have flexible deployment environment. OpenShift supports a wide range of programming language, framework, and databases, providing developers with a flexible development environment that can accommodate a variety of technology stacks. Also, we have improved collaboration. OpenShift provides a centralized platform for collaboration, allowing developers to work together more easily and efficiently, and streamlining the development process. Also, OpenShift provides us add-ons and services. OpenShift provides access to a range of add-ons and services such as databases, monitoring tools, and messaging system, allowing developers to build and deploy e-commerce application with the necessary components. Second, we have OpenShift operators. OpenShift operators is a software component in OpenShift that helps automate the management and deployment of containerized application on the OpenShift platform. Operators provides a higher level of abstraction than traditional infrastructure management, allowing administrators to manage complex applications and their underlying components as a single unit. OpenShift operators are designed to automate tasks such as installation, updates, backups, and scaling of applications. They can also provide additional functionality, such as monitoring and logging, to help manage and maintain the health of the applications. Operators can be developed and provided by the application vendor or a third party, allowing business to easily manage and deploy applications from a variety of sources. In summary, OpenShift operators provide a high level of automation and abstraction for managing applications on the OpenShift platform, making it easier for administrators to manage complex applications and their underlying components. Then we have several benefits for the infrastructure when using OpenShift as a platform for hosting e-commerce applications, like automated provisioning. OpenShift automates the provision of infrastructure, reducing the time and effort required to set up and configure infrastructure. Also, we have scalability. OpenShift provides a highly scalable infrastructure, allowing business to easily handle spikes in traffic and grow as needed. Then we have improved security. OpenShift provides a secure platform for hosting e-commerce applications with features such as network segmentations, role-based access control, and automated security updates. Also, we have cost saving. OpenShift container-based architecture reduces the cost associated with traditional virtualized infrastructure, providing cost saving for business. Also, through the OpenShift, we can achieve the flexible deployment options. OpenShift provides our support a range of deployment options, including on-prem, public cloud, and hybrid cloud, allowing business to deploy e-commerce application in the way that best meets their needs. Also, OpenShift provides several security benefits for organizations that hosting e-commerce application. Network segmentation. OpenShift provides network segmentation, allowing e-commerce application to be isolated from other application and resources, improving security and reducing the risk of security breaches. Role-based access control, OpenShift provides role-based access control, allowing administrators to control who can access and manage e-commerce application, improving security and reducing the risk of unauthorized access. Also, we have automatic security updates. OpenShift provides automatic security updates, ensuring that e-commerce applications are always running with the latest security patches and reducing the risk of security vulnerabilities. Compliance, OpenShift provides a platform that is compliant with a range of security and privacy standards, including PCI DSS, HIPAA, and SOC 2, making it easier for organizations to meet their security and compliance requirements. Also, OpenShift provides a secure container environment, allowing e-commerce application to be isolated from one another and reducing the risk of security breaches. Overall, OpenShift provides a secure platform for hosting e-commerce applications, reducing the risk of security breaches and helping organizations meet their security and compliance requirements. So, how Royal Cyber can help you to develop and create a migration approach? Royal Cyber is an IT consulting and solution provider that helps business to develop a migration approach for their e-commerce applications to OpenShift. Royal Cyber has a team of experienced consultants and engineers who can help business to understand the benefits of migrating to OpenShift and develop a migration plan that meets their unique needs and requirements. Some of the steps that Royal Cyber may help business with when developing a migration approach for their e-commerce application to OpenShift include assessment. Royal Cyber can assist a business existing e-commerce environment and determine the best approach for migrating to OpenShift. Planning. Royal Cyber can help business plan and prepare for their migration to OpenShift, including identify any technical or operational challenges that may need to be addressed. Also, Royal Cyber can help business migrate their e-commerce application to OpenShift, including setting up the necessary infrastructure and migrating data. Royal Cyber can help business optimize their OpenShift environment for their e-commerce applications, including configuring and tuning the environment for performance, security, and scalability. Royal Cyber also provides ongoing support and maintenance services to help business keep their e-commerce application running smoothly on OpenShift. Overall, Royal Cyber can help business to develop a migration approach for their e-commerce application to OpenShift, providing the expertise, tools, support needed to ensure a successful migration. Also, Royal Cyber helps you to take the advantage of our streamlined process to address our specific needs. Data portability, depending on your choice and business need, we help in identifying and setting the limits for controlling application data, storage, replication, deployment, and usage. Also, we have user management towards ensuring efficient directory services. We help in identifying potential risks for IT administrators, allowing directory services with user management process and creating specific roles. Also, we have security towards ensuring adequate security. We help in sensitizing corporate data, removing any threats, and setting place a robust compliance mechanism. Also, we have scalability features. Where user load is poised for growth, we help clients in taking advantage of the dynamic scaling capabilities as provided by the underlying application servers. Also, we have case study for one of our pages client who are looking to migrate their existing environment from IBM Cloud Private to OpenShift container platform. So in this migration, our client was looking to get scalability, high availability, and smooth applications. Also, they want to reduce the downtime during the deployment. During this migration, we had some business challenges like integration of CI/CD with OpenShift. Also, we have secure and handy security context constraint. Also, we had issues with integration with container image registry integrations. So what solutions we propose at the time of migrations? We modified and updated the Helm charts to support the deployment and our process of the code build. Also, in this migration, we enabled the security context constraints, which limits pod access to the host environment. Also, we created the backup and restore strategy for OpenShift cluster and the application deployments. Also, in this migration, we configure and set up logging and monitoring stack using OpenShift operators to gain end-to-end complete visibility on infra and application levels. So what we achieve in this migration? We have improved high availability with the OpenShift cluster. Also, in this migration, we achieve increase the infrastructure health and persist the critical data. We implemented the stronger security policies than any other orchestration tool like Kubernetes. Also, we have better visibility on the cluster and application with unified logging and monitoring state deployment. Now, I would like to invite Daya Ahmed to show us some walkthrough with OpenShift console. Hi, Daya.
Thank you, Kamran. Hi, everyone. So OpenShift can be managed using CLI or using ABI or using OpenShift Web Console. Let's have a look on OpenShift Web Console. Basically, it's a browser-based user interface to manage most of OpenShift administration and application tasks. It provides a cluster overview like number of nodes we have, number of pods, storage classes, resource utilization, overall resource utilization of the cluster like CPU, memory, file system, network transfer, and boot count. The console has two types of views, administrator view and developer view. Administrator view for most of common administrative tasks like installing, configuring operators, managing workloads like deployments, pods, stateful sets, secrets, and so on, managing network like services, routes, managing storage, including persistent volume claims, persistent volumes, storage classes, snapshots. Also, observability tab to view dashboards, metrics, and manage alerts. And also managing cluster nodes and machines and configuring auto-scaling. Also viewing and managing users, groups, service accounts, and some other administration tasks like configuring CRDs and perform updates. As for developer overview, it's for managing the application resources within a namespace, including deploying application, configuring builds, configuring and creating config maps, secrets, and projects. Also, OpenShift keep tracks OpenShift updates, and from console you can track the updates and manage OpenShift updates using a few clicks. As an example of e-commerce, HCL Commerce can be deployed using Helm charts, and this chart will deploy all the resources needed, including deployments, service routes, config maps, secrets. And this Helm chart deploys the needed services to provide communication between the components and each others. And it also creates ingress, and these ingresses will be translated into OpenShift routes behind the scenes to provide outside access to e-commerce. That's it for me. Back to the Heroj. Thanks.
Thanks, Daya. Hello, everyone. I am covering IT managed services, in which IT managed services multiple verticals. They specifically cover Red Hat OpenShift. So in terms of the Red Hat OpenShift managed services vertical, we have first of all create a dashboard, and from the dashboard, we are monitoring the traffic management as well as the performance management. The third aspect and most important is security manage alerts and monitoring mechanism also we have. The day-to-day activity, which or troubleshooting or alerts, we covered under the troubleshooting options. And the build and deployment with any the OpenShift environment, we have the continuous integration part. The processes which we have, OpenShift processes and with the establishment and all, we also cover for the developers and all. Apart from this, the miscellaneous responsibility, the IT operational activities are so daily, we are sending technical reports to the client, in which we covered the multiple parameters. So it will be a transparency between both of them, as well as a weekly mechanism which we have, the number of tickets we resolved, how the overall IT management module is, or the best practices we followed, all cover under this. This entire model, support model, we based on the ITL framework, we have a very well organized, in which we have a three different team, L1, L2, L3. L1 is more in terms of the installation, configuration part, the day-to-day activities, monitoring, or any alerts are there. They are close eye on all those alerts and all. L2 is more in terms of the root cause analysis of the issues which come from L1, which is beyond L1 bucket. They are not resolved, then L2 will be responsible for that. And they're not resolve only the issues, even they're providing a root cause analysis of the issue. L3 is the expert team of the specific domain is. They are more in terms of the change advisable recommendation, any bug related or analysis. All those things will be covered by L3 team. The project highlight which we have. So the post-migration and doing this overall the IT management support, the downtime is lowered. Our entire team is monitoring this 24/7 kind of environment. We follow the SLAs. And our entire team is monitoring supports, so problem resolutions and all reduced. Our entire IT managed services model divided into four different categories. And every category, there are multiple subcategories also there. So start with the traditional environment, in which we have a data center, kind of the client have on-premises IT infrastructure. In that scenario, we have a network operations, security operations, and support services. IT asset management, we covered under that one. Continuous monitoring, our 24/7 support teams continuously monitoring stuff. And the IT facility management is more in terms of if a client required any specific domain-wise consultant based on the key skills, we are providing a facility management services also. Moving to the next level, create a cloud environment. So we already have a tie-up with Azure as well as AWS. And already serving to multiple clients, DevOps, Jenkins, the CI/CD pipeline, Shans and all. Importantly, we covered under this one Office 365 as well as the G Suite support also, and the public and private, both the clouds we are providing is support. And third level is the combination of public and private also, we are providing a support on those. Moving to the next level, it's application managed services, in which we open for all the sector as well as the technology. So it's more in terms of the post-production minor or major bug fixing as well as the migration support we are providing. Last but not least, it is more in terms of the specific L1 level of supports required on those. Those also we cover under this. Why Royal Cyber is? What are the unique features Royal Cyber IT managed services have? So the most important is we have a 24/7 environment, our global production support center. From there, we providing across the globe our client supports. Our entire the team, the IT managed services team sitting at our on-site as well as the offshore offices. So they have ITIL as well as the ITSM certified consultant. Going to the next, once you client onboarded, the new client onboarded, so what the best practices we have? We have Royal Cyber have internal ITIL as well as ISO 27002 certified committee who have to review each and every IT managed services account periodically, every quarters. And if they find a gap during the entire process flow and all, so accordingly, they will inform to the client as well as the internal spoke who is providing a support for those client. Overall IT managed services follow ITIL best practices as well as industry standard norms. Thank you. Thanks, everyone.